Sean.
Yes, sir.
Teach me a magic trick.
I got it. I'm about to teach you how to take any ping pong ball, put it in another hand, and make it vanish.
What?
This one's really easy. What you're gonna do is you're gonna make the action that you're gonna put in your hand, but your thumb is gonna hold it. It's gonna look like this. And then you pretend like it's in this hand, but in reality it's in this hand. All together it looks like this. Vanish, then you have it in this hand.
Sean.
Yeah?
Teach me a magic trick.
I got it. I'm about to teach you how to turn one card into another.
What?
This is really easy. All you need is two cards, and what you want to do is put them back to back, like this. Hold it in the two corners, and all you do is, as you shake, you take your index finger and you turn it around. All together, it looks like this. Bam, it changes.
Sean. Teach me a magic trick.
I got it. I'm about to teach you how to take a cap off and make it vanish, just like
what?
That. To do this, it's really easy. All you have to do is start off with the cap off, cover it with your hand. You're gonna use your nail to slide against this little edge right here. Slide your nail across, and it's gonna look like you're taking it off, like that. And it vanished.
Today I'll be showing you exactly how I became a really good artist. So I started out by finding pictures that had a lot of value and tracing them. I then went on and colored the entire picture so I would have a base. And then I used a cotton ball to blend. This is what it looked like after. I then went on and looked at all the shadows that I see and started coloring those in. It doesn't really matter if it's neat or not, as long as it's laid in the right place. Do not use the tip of your pencil to shade, use the side. I then went on and blended out the shadows as well. I repeated the process several more times to add more dimension to my drawing. Notice where the highlights are, they're usually focused around the nose, lips, and eyes. I used the kneaded eraser to erase the lightest parts of the face. You can also use a regular eraser, but I couldn't find one, so I just used that one. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me on Instagram. I'll answer them. Also, don't forget to like and follow for more.
Sean.
What's up?
Teach me a magic trick.
I got you. I'm about to teach you how to take any amount of water, pour into a cup, mix it around a little bit, and then bam, ice. This is actually really easy. All you need is a sponge. Take the sponge, you put it inside the cup, add your ice cubes in, and that sponge is gonna absorb all of that liquid. It's gonna look like it turns into ice.
Sean.
What's up?
Teach me a magic trick.
Oh, I got you. I'm about to teach you how to take any ring, and on the count of three, two, one, vanish and reappear on my ring finger.
No way.
This one's really easy. What you're gonna do is you're gonna pretend to grab the ring, but really you're dropping it. And while their eyes are in this hand, what you're doing with the other hand is you're placing the ring on your finger. You make it vanish, and then you show it on your ring finger.
Sean.
What's up?
Teach me a magic trick.
I got it. I'm about to teach you how to take any sticky note, rip it up, snap my fingers, and it's back to normal. To do this, you need two sticky notes. One you crumple in your hand, and the other that you're gonna rip up. Crumple it up, and then you're gonna switch it with the other one. Magically restored.
Keep the butt on if you don't wanna cry. Dice your onion. Chop up your green onions. Greens and whites, we don't discriminate around here. Your garlic, minced. Mince it real good. Chinese sausage. Two eggs, a few splashes of fish sauce. Heat up your oil. Make sure that it's hot. Wait until your onions develop color and a little char, then add your sausages. Slide everything to the side. Then you add your rice. Soy sauce, fish sauce, sriracha. Combine it all together.
Justice.
Thank you.
Bro, what are you doing? Bro, what the f*** are you doing?
Wait, I'll give you one more.
You sure?
Yeah, it's
a burger. Oh, can you call the cops on him?
Today I'm going to show you how to make your own stones to paint on. You guys keep asking me about some of these perfect stones, and some of them are handmade, and this is how I do it. I use gypsum to make my stones. It's a very strong, durable product. If you can't find gypsum where you are, you can also use plaster of Paris, and it is also a cheaper option. I then pour them into these molds that I got from Happy Dotting Company. A big tip is that you have to tap them on the sides to let the air bubbles come to the bottom of the stone. Otherwise, the air bubbles will be at the top of the stone, which is the side that you paint on. Now that I have all the bubbles to the bottom of the stone, I then take a paper towel and just kind of dab it on the back side, and that gets rid of those bubbles, so I have less sanding to do at the end. And that's how I make my stones.
Okay, I'm bored in the house and I'm in the house bored.
bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a motherfucker in a house bored and I'm bored in a motherfucker in a house bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house, bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house, bored. I'm bored in a motherfucker in a house.
Just pick one.
Anyone. Oh, you can see.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
See. Can you write your name?
Okay. Shallots, keep the butt on if you don't want to cry since it is in the onion family. Grate this carrot. Cut up your mung bean noodles. Don't want shrimp chunks. I want shrimp paste. Cut up your woodier mushroom. Pat dry your carrots, shallots, mushrooms, and noodles. Mung bean noodles. Minced shrimp. Ground pork. Add in your woodier mushroom. The shallots. And the carrots. 2 tablespoons of fish sauce, 2 teaspoons of sugar, 1 egg. Mix it up. Warm water, 1 teaspoon of sugar, white vinegar. Dip your rice paper in, dry surface, dry off, heaping tablespoon. Shape it into an egg roll, like a burrito. You tuck the sides, tightly roll it up like an egg roll. Fry it on medium high heat. Sweet chili sauce. Nukjam.
These two absolutely love to taste test. These treats came out so good, they're going to love them.
You drooling? Look, you literally are making a pile of drool.
Let's see how long it takes them to eat the treats this time. I've been getting this question a lot. Cooper is the lighter golden on the right, and Murphy is the darker golden on the left. This is Murphy's way of saying he wants more treats.
Are you waiting?
Now time to try the dog paw mold treats. As you can see, these treats were a huge hit with our boys, and we hope your pup loves them too.
You know, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide.
How to wash your vulva. First, I lather up the whole body, including the triangle of the mons pubis with the soap. I let the soapy water kind of run down. Don't put it directly between the legs. Then just use your hands and some water. You don't need a whole lot of cleaning in between the lips. What's more important is to get on the outside of the small lips or the labia minora and to clean in those folds. After that, gently pull up the clitoral hood and clean around that area. And that's all you need to do, water only.
How to sneak into the movies for a dollar. Or more specifically, how I snuck into the movies for a dollar. What you gonna need? A dollar. Okay, but seriously, this only works during the summer months. But Regal and AMC have this dollar summer program. It's usually on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. And it goes for like the entire summer from like June to August. And it's a dollar. Here's the catch. It's a dollar, but the movie starts at 10 a.m. So a lot of families and schools, they show older kids movies like Despicable Me and Alvin and Chipmunks. However, anyone can pay the $1. So me and my friend went. We paid the dollar and watched 45 minutes of Alvin and Chipmunks. But what we really wanted to see was Jurassic World, which started at like 11. So when it was around like 10:45, we started walking out. But the minute we stepped out of our theater, there was a guy there with a clipboard. We immediately just ducked into the bathroom. We're like, what do we do? What do we do? What the heck? Why does he have a clipboard? We're like, I don't know, but the movie's starting. So we made a plan. There was signals, there was whistles, there was everything. I went out first. Pop my head out, see if there was anybody there. Make sure clipboard guy had left. There was no one, so we ran. We were cool though. We got in there and I was paranoid the whole time. Every time someone walked in, we jumped.
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you. I'm about to teach you how you can take any ring, take it right off, and throw it right back on.
What?
To do this, it's actually really easy. You're not taking off the ring. All you're doing is you're coming over your hand, and you're switching the two fingers like that. And then when you throw it up, you just switch it again. In the front, it looks like this. You pretend to take it off. It's really right there. And just like that.
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you. I'm about to teach you how you can take a phone and literally put it inside of a balloon, just like that. To do this, it's actually really easy. All you need to do is blow up the balloon, and all you do is you push the phone against the balloon. When you do so, it traps the phone inside, and it looks like it's inside the balloon.
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you. I'm about to show you how you can flick cards out of a deck.
What?
To do this, it's actually really easy. Take your index finger, push your card down, and it'll flick up. When you time it right, it looks cool. Also, huge thank you for almost 10 million followers. You all are awesome.
Story time. I got these rusty-ass workout bars. Let me show you. The problem with home gyms is many people don't like to work out in the same environment that they live. So I decided to put a gym outside. I built a gazebo, bought all the necessary weights and equipment that I needed, and bam! I was in action. Problem is, sometimes we get lazy, and instead of re-racking our weights, we'll just leave them in the grass. On occasions, we get rain. You leave the weights in the grass, they're gonna get rusty. But I'm gonna beat this rust. Most people use wire brushes and be scrubbing all day, but I decided to go with a power drill and some wire brush drill bits. I lock my drill bits into my power tool and begin scrubbing. The rust began to come off immediately. The comparison between the rusty bar and the buffed bar was night and day. And when I needed to get up close and personal, I put on my cheap-ass trusty goggles and did a spin maneuver to speed up the process. Soon my entire bar was cleared of rust. I wiped it down with paper towels, then grabbed my trusty can of rust resistant spray paint. I'm going with black. I sprayed the entire bar black, and oh my god, it looks good. So if your equipment ever gets rusty, don't throw it out. Just do exactly what I did.
Babe.
What?
Let's go to the movie theaters.
What? I thought it was closed.
No, it's not. Come on, I got you a ticket. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Good afternoon. May I please have your ticket?
We're here for Onward.
Welcome!
What the heck? So you again?
A smack bowl one?
Oh my
damn!
God, this looks good.
A smack bowl, yeah. Looks smack.
Are you excited, baby?
Super duper excited.
Alright, let's go.
Alright, babe, let's find Onward. Nope. Nope. It's a restroom.
Hey.
Onward!
Hello. Enjoy your guys' movie.
I appreciate it, man.
Wow, it's so pretty in here.
Do you like it, baby?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Hang with Apple Pay.
The boys are ready to bake. First, I'm going to add 1 cup of peanut butter, 1 cup of organic pumpkin puree, 1 mashed banana. Mix all that good stuff up, and then gradually add in 2 cups of whole wheat flour.
You a happy boy?
1 happy doggo and 1 doggo that does not like to wait for his treats to be ready. Once everything is mixed, I knead the dough and then roll it out with a rolling pin. This is clearly exhausting Cooper. Of course, I have to take a moment and give this good boy some ear scratchies. Now just cookie cut, roll, and repeat. I bake these in the oven at 350, about 10 minutes for a soft and chewy treat, and about 20 minutes for a hard and crunchy treat. For how to store these treats, look at the comments below. They are ready to go into the oven. Don't forget to check out our taste testing video if you want to see how much the boys love these treats.
Alright, let's do this.
Alright, so we're about 20 minutes in, and this is where we're at so far. It's smaller than my hand, and we still got all these, so...
Alright guys, a little update. This is an hour in. That's it. It's as big as my hand.
Alright guys, we are now 2 hours into the rubber band ball. It is looking pretty good. You guys, I've been working on this for so long, it's actually dark now.
I can't believe I just spent 4 hours making this rubber band ball, and in part 2 we're gonna make it twice as big with all these. Let's do it.
Since you guys blew up my last video, we are going to attempt to make the world's largest rubber band ball.
All right, guys, we are about an hour in, and it honestly doesn't look like I did anything yet. All right, guys, we are about 2 hours in right now. It is getting really big. We're gonna do a bounce test in there.
We just broke the roof.
All right, guys, it's been 3 hours. This thing is getting huge. The sun is going down, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to finish in time, but we're gonna try.
4 hours in, and that's all I have left, but it's getting dark.
If this video blows up, I'll go back to Target and buy as many rubber bands as I can buy, and we'll make this thing even bigger in part three.
So to get a decent bead, I'm gonna show you something you don't wanna do.
You don't want your brush to be dripping wet like this, because you'll just get that. And you don't wanna drain it completely on both sides, because you'll get very thin, dry, nothing to work with. You also don't want to drag it through the powder, which is a way a lot of people seem to learn. This is kind of what you get, which isn't very helpful. What you do want to do is submerge it in the monomer, submerge your brush, make sure that there's no bubbles, lightly tap it. The brush is still wet, but not too wet. Tap it, and then you want to bounce it lightly in the powder. Workable bead.
Someone explain to me what's happening. Oh, look, I have a glass of milk and a shot glass, and somehow all the liquid in this glass fits in this glass. Look it, look, all of it. What in the hell? What's happening?
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you.
I'm about to show you how you can take a pair of earpods, take the end, snip it right off, just like that, and then magically restore it.
What?
To do this is actually really easy. You need a normal set of earbuds, and then you're gonna need to take a second one and cut a piece like this. What you do is take this extra piece and put it at the top, snip it off. All you do is grab that piece and show the rest of it. Magic.
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you.
I'm about to teach you how you can eat the cream of an Oreo and magically make it refill up.
What?
All you need to do is only eat half of the cream. When you show from the front, it'll look empty, but as you shake, you turn it around and it's gonna look filled.
Sean, teach me a magic trick.
I got you.
I'm about to teach you how to force a card. Do me a favor and say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
Right there? Go and memorize your card. You got it?
Yes.
Was it the King of Diamonds?
What?
What you're gonna do is you're gonna go through the cards one by one. Whenever they say stop, you're gonna grab the entire packet and the bottom card, and bam, you force the card.
Listen, bro. I understand what you're saying, but I'ma help them understand what you're saying. Basically, this how the girl be.
Where? Who? You been where? Where who? For real. Oh, really? That's how you feel?
And the guys be like, asking all them questions. Asking all them questions, why you asking all them questions? Making statements, who? Asking all them questions. Asking all them questions, why you asking all them questions? Making statements, who? Where you been? How much did you spend? Yeah, I trust you. Now unlock your phone. Who is this? How? See?
I have a question real quick. If I pay you $10,000, would you be my girlfriend? Would you be my girlfriend? Because I'm a famous TikToker. You would be my girlfriend? You have an Instagram? What is it?
Wait.
Quarantine snacks part 55? Let's go.
Melt a tablespoon of butter into your mug, then add some flour, baking powder, milk. Almond milk works just fine. And this part's optional, but I added a tablespoon of maple syrup. Mix that baby up until it's nice and smooth. And in a separate dish, mix together some brown sugar and cinnamon. Evenly pour that topping over top of your batter, and I kind of failed here, but try to swirl it up so you get that nice cinnamon bun look. Microwave this bad boy for a minute and 25 seconds, and you got yourself the easiest cinnamon bun mug cake ever. If you're gonna make one of my recipes, you gotta make this one. It's so good. In other words, it slaps!
Since it's 86 degrees out here today, we decided to show you how we make watermelon sherbet. I put into my blender 1 cup of non-fat plain Greek yogurt, and then I add some watermelon. Then just blend the two ingredients together. Once blended, I fill the molds. We have Mr. Impatient here who does not want to wait for them to freeze. I let them freeze for about 4 hours. Once frozen, I take them out of the molds. Now the boys' favorite part, taste testing. When I make these for myself, I use vanilla Greek yogurt, and they taste so good. As you can see here, these two boys are two very different types of eaters.
You're a mess, Murphy.
Cooper loves to savor his treats. And Murphy always has hope that Cooper's going to share.
There's a baby coming, so we did a quick hairdo that'll last for a while. I know she seems like she has a lot of hair, but she also has alopecia.
This is an autoimmune disease that causes balding, but to combat that, we are going to make 9 cornrows across the top, and from the back, I'm going to start at the nape and braid that hair up towards where the bald spot is. While doing this, I'm going to actually leave the ends loose. Now, I did 6 across the bottom, 9 across the top, and with the loose ends, I began to stitch them with needle and thread to cover up where the bald spot is. Now I'll crochet like normal. I've made several videos on that, so be sure to check them out. But with this braiding pattern, you can pull it up. It actually looks like they may be individual, even though they're not. You'll notice the bald spot is completely covered. Be sure to follow for more tutorials and pray for a healthy baby.